When it went down, it was so hard to breathe. I gave up everything. Hey guys, welcome back to my second episode of Redecorating My Room series. So in this video, we're going to be redecorating and redoing my desk, kind of office section of my room. So I have these two giant blank walls, and it wasn't a very inspiring space, and I felt like it had a lot of potential. So to find out how I turned this space into this, please keep watching. Alright, to get started, I'm going to start off with the wall above my desk area. So I wanted this to be my main focal point because this is what I'm always looking up above while I'm studying and I'm at my desk. So I decided I was going to install this white shelf from Home Depot that I'm going to install at the very top of my wall. And so I bought four of these brackets and my uncle helped me. We used a stud finder to find the studs in the wall. And we installed the brackets in and we put the shelf on top and secured the brackets into the shelf. Then you have a nice, pretty, and secure shelf. Another way to vamp up your space is to paint and redo your furniture. I already painted my desk, but here I'm going to paint the stool that I found from the thrift shop for a couple dollars, and I'm going to paint it white, and I'm going to paint the seat a nice coral shade that I'm going to be using throughout this whole video. So a trick to redoing a certain space of your room is to having a certain theme of colors. So for me, I picked the colors white, gold, and coral because those are my top three favorite colors. And I really recommend you doing this because it just provides a nice theme and solidity to your whole environment. So for example, you could do turquoise, pink, and white, or green and black with silver accents, or just anything. So sticking with my theme, I decided to take my black easel that was covered in paint and I decided to spray paint it gold, and so it would just be this beautiful accent in my room that really glistened, and I just love the way it came out. I started off with this type of brand's gold spray paint, and then I Pinterest the best gold spray paint, and it was this one. So if you're gonna spray paint anything gold, I would really recommend this brand. And this is the way they came out. So next I decided to build a gallery that's going to go under the shelf on this wall, and so the next step would be to gather frames that you already have or go buy some, a bunch of different sizes, whatever works and whatever you have will do. And then I also grabbed a few things that I could use to hold some of the random papers that we always get. I found this bulletin board at a garage sale for $2, and we're going to try to figure out where we want it on our wall. So to figure out what kind of layout we want on our wall, instead of just placing everything on the ground or holding up the frames to the wall, I found this really cool trick where you take newspaper and you tape them and you cut them into the size of the shape that you want onto your wall. And this makes it so much easier for you to figure out where you want each thing to go on your wall, and you can play around with it and figure out what style you want. And this is the layout that I came up with. So next I wanted my bulletin board to match the theme of my room, and you guessed it, I decided to spray paint it white with this glossy spray paint for a cheap makeover. So next we're going to learn how to make this DIY watercolor calendar. I'm sure you guys have seen the calendars where you guys use paint samples, and it's kind of similar to that, but this time we're making our own little panels. So what you'll need is just a regular frame. I think bigger the better because it gives you more room to write on. And so you're just going to pop out the back, and then you're going to take out the current image inside of it. And you can use the paper on the back of it to glue all your panels on. But your materials are going to be paintbrushes, a type of watercolor paper, or something thick enough for watercolor, and water, watercolor of course. Typically we're going to start to make all these little squares. Basically what we're going to do is make a giant piece of paper with watercolor designs on it and then cut that out. So the first step is to just lay a bunch of water onto your paper, and then you're going to add the color to the water. So you can just dribble this in, dribble, and just pat this in, just add some color. And the trick to watercolor is just layering it. What you can also do is add splatter marks by just splashing on your paintbrush and just flicking it on, and you get little tiny more flecks of detail into it. And so you just let it dry, And remember that coral paint from earlier? Yeah, so I'm using that and I'm painting the other half. And so I just cut out the panels when it dried, and I also added a gold strip and a light corally shade. And then I cut them out into squares, which is 2 inches by 2.5 inches, in case anyone's wondering. And then I also cut out really tiny little circles to write the letter of each day of the week on the very top, like so. I also used some watercolor tiles to make the title for the name of the month. And here's what everything looks like. I really love how everything came out. Just glue it down with any glue that you have. I specifically used Yes Glue, which is one of my art professors swears by, but any glue will work. And this is what the finished product looks like. You and I will both get by. Just promise you won't. Next, we're gonna make a watercolor gold and coral pineapple. So it's gonna be a very similar concept. I can make a further depth tutorial on this if you guys would like, but basically you just lay water down in the shape of a pineapple as you like, and it always helps to have reference photos. So I'm just filling it in with some corally watercolor. And then on the top, since I want it to be a little bit of an ombre effect, I added some regular diluted gold paint because I couldn't really find a nice watercolor gold paint. So I just did that. I let it dry and I overlaid it with more gold paint on the top so it was more pigmented. And then I just let it dry, and this is the finished product. I freaking love pineapples. Just look at that shine. So now that we have all of our main pieces ready for our gallery, it's time to put it up. So just put a nail in the center of the newspaper that you hung and hang it, and you're good. So I brought in some smaller items for the gallery. I got this lion head from Ross, and I actually gold leafed this frame from a garage sale I found. And to make this pretty paintbrush stroke pattern, I just put on a few of my favorite colors, and I added a little cool tones, I added a mint. So yeah, brought some cool tones into the frame. So next we're going to personalize. I got these pretty push pins from Target from the Nate Berkus collection that I'm going to use on my bulletin board. I also got gold washi tape from Target as well for $1 to $3. There's going to be a lot of things from Target in this video. And then I just hung up a few of my favorite things, like this article with Lisa Kudrow. Doesn't she look so cute and happy here? Anyway, I got these gold scissors from Target as well and from the Nate Berkus line, and I just hung it up on the bulletin board with a few push pins so it always has a little home. And then you can add whatever you want. I also hung this empty picture frame that with the gold washi tape I'm going to tape my syllabus on, so I can always have it right in front of me and remind me what to do. And for the other work, anything like glass, even with the pineapple, you can write on with Expo marker because it's washable and it's just another great way to stay organized. And so here I'm just filling up this with some sentimental memories and those little pieces of paper that we seem to always gather up. So now onto the shelves. So I'm also going to fill it up with some decor and some books. I'm using this Agate Gem bookend from TJ Maxx that I'm in love with. I think it's so pretty. And I'm also going to add some Christmas lights. I also added some twinkling lights and wrapped it around the wall because I just think they're so pretty. And then I added a globe and that I made. And if you guys want to see a video to that, I'll link it in the description bar below. And then I also had these books in that I just spray painted the sides of it, so it would just match my theme a little bit more. You can call me crazy, but I actually think it looks really nice. And it fits the white theme pretty well. And so I just added some few decor items. I hope you guys get a little bit of inspiration of what I did here, but obviously with your shelf, you can do whatever you want. It's just a great way to display your books and some decor. So next, going on to the desk. So this is what I had before, in case you guys don't remember. I had that pink lamp, which I'm now switching in for this more pretty desk lamp from Target. This is the name, and I got the matching lampshade. I just really liked it, and I actually decided to gold leaf the bottom of it because it was silver, and I know, I'm crazy, I know. And so I actually added this tray from this type of chocolate, and a tray just makes things more organized. So in the tray, really quickly, I'm just adding a tape dispenser from the Nate Berkus line as well. And I am also going to add this little gold mini vase from the Target dollar section. Seriously, go look there. There's some really cute stuff. And then I picked up this little $1 display easel from the dollar store. I think it's a really cute way to display your phone while you're on your desk. And lastly, I added this little light bulb that I used as a little vase. Flowers are always a great idea to put on your desk to liven up the space. And then for the other side, I got these gold mechanical pencils and pens from the Taller Dollar section as well. And I'm going to put them in this little Totoro Miyazaki cup that I got from Japan. And then I'm also adding a gold stapler from the Nate Burgess line. Add your planner and some journals onto your desk, and then you are done. And this is totally optional, but I wanted to stick with the gold theme. So I picked up this cheap laptop case that was gold from Amazon, and I put it onto my laptop. And I think everything just tied in really well together. And now going on to the other side. So I really wanted to add something into this little blank wall behind the easel. And so I decided to add a tapestry. And so I looked in our linen closet and I found this pink lace fabric that my mom used to use as curtains. And I wanted to make this ombre tapestry. And so how you can do that is I took the fabric, I decided to soak one half of it in just regular water. And then I took the wet half and I just dipped it into a bucket of watered down bleach. And then I just did that with all of them at the same time. And then I let that sit all day long. And so I let it sit. And then once I thought it was done and I liked the results, I put it into the wash on delicate with fabric softener and then the dryer on also delicate. And it came out like this. And I just love the way the white lace fades into the pink lace. And I just love, love, love it. And so it already had a pocket on top because it was made for curtains. So I just purchased a dowel from a local hardware store and I just slid it through. And then I found some twine, which I just wrapped around each end. And you can also add hot glue under if you like it to be more secure. And then I just added a nail into the wall and I hung it and I was done. And so I really hope you guys try this easy tapestry tutorial. And so I also wanted to add something into this space. So I decided to get a hammock and put it in this little corner and just make optimal use of the space that I had. So we installed a very strong hook into the ceiling and have an adult help you with this because I really wanted to make sure it's safe because you're putting all of your body weight onto it. But then I ordered this hammock from Etsy. I will leave the link in the bottom description below. And I just love, love it. I'm obsessed. I love reading on it. I love doing work on it. I'm obsessed. And don't think we forgot about this little pink little stool. I like to use a lot of my desk space when I'm working, so I'm actually going to use it to put my laptop on so I can play Netflix while I'm working, or just if I'm, you know, just another little home for the laptop. And so this is the finished product. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And don't forget to like if you feel inspired by this video. I will come up with more episodes toward this series. So I really hope you guys keep up. And I love you. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye. Every game you play, every night you stay, I'll be watching you. Okay.